Well, hey there, native plant enthusiasts. This is Santino, Education Coordinator for Bowman's Hill Wildflower Preserve, coming at you with another native plant highlight. Today, I want to showcase one of my favorite native deciduous trees. This is Sassafras albidum, or Sassafras, in the Lauricella family. This tree loves moist, well-drained soils and is commonly found in open woodlands and along fence rows and the like. It is super cool. And in terms of wildlife value, while it's not that high, it is still one of the host plants for the swallowtail butterfly. But in terms of human history and humankind, the uses of this plant are quite great and diverse. All plants, all parts of this plant have been used during human history, from the leaves all the way through to the roots. Back in early colonist time, this plant was second only to tobacco in terms of its importance as an export back to Europe. The wood of this plant was used in both shipbuilding and furniture making. The twigs of this plant were used as toothbrushes because of the antiseptic and medicinal qualities of them. The leaves of the plant, when dried and ground, create file powder, which is a traditional ingredient in Creole gumbo. And one of my favorite beverages, root beer, got its original flavoring from the safrole oils of this plant. So safrole, sassafras, until the 1960s, when the FDA determined that those safrole oils were a carcinogen, and they were removed from the soft drink as a flavoring. So today, the modern day root beers that you drink are flavored artificially with artificial sassafras flavoring. One of the coolest things to note about this plant is some sharp-eyed naturalists will see that its leaves are pretty unique. So if we look, you'll see that this plant has not one, not two, but three distinct leaf shapes that you can find on a single plant. So first up and most common is probably the one right here that you see, the trilobed, or what I like to refer to, especially during the spooky season of October, as the ghost-shaped leaf. Ooh! Sorry, couldn't resist. Second, you'll see that it has a two-lobed leaf, or a mitten. And lastly, you'll find leaves here without a lobe, just kind of a single oval. Just your traditional leaf shape. So three different leaf shapes on the same plant. A really cool ID feature for this plant. So I do have some sad news. Despite how amazing and rich this plant is, and rich in its cultural history, I should say, it is facing new challenges in terms of the laurel wilt disease, which is a wilting disease caused by the red bay ambrosia beetle, or I should say it's caused by the fungus that is carried by the red bay ambrosia beetle. So folks in the southeast and in the Midwest, their sassafrases are slowly starting to die because of this fungal disease. Not much is known about it. They're still doing heavily research on trying to figure out how to stop the spread of that disease. But it's just one thing to note that a new challenge that's facing in the history of this plant. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you enjoy this plant as much as I do. And until next time, I encourage you all to keep on experiencing what's natural and learning what's native. All right, take care and have a great one.